Hello everyone, I am Mrs. Sunita M. In this video, the topic covered is Structured Query Language Set Operations. All the set operations like union, intersect and except are covered. Learning outcome: at the end of the session, students will be able to write the query using set operations like union, union all, intersect, intersect all, except and except all. The SQL set operation is used to combine the two or more SQL select statements. The set operations on the relations are given below. The set operations union, intersect and except operate on relations and corresponds to the relational algebra operation union, intersection and minus. To retain all duplicates, we use the corresponding multiset version union all, intersect all and except all. The relation participating in the set operation must be compatible, that is, they must have the same set of attributes. Set operation union and union all. The union operator is used to combine the result set of two or more select statements. Each select statement within the union must have the same number of columns. The column must also have the similar data type. The columns in each select statement must also be in the same order. The union clause produces distinct values in the result set, and to fetch the duplicate values too, union all must be used instead of just union. Syntax for union is select column names from table 1, union select column names from table 2. The syntax for union all is select column name from table 1, union all, select column name from table 2. The column names in the result set are usually equal to the column names in the first select statement in the union and union all. For all set operation, we are going to consider the two relation depositor, which denote the association between the customer and the bank account that the customer have, and the borrower, which denote the association between the customer and the bank loan that the customer have taken. The relation depositor consists of two fields, customer name and the account number, while the relation borrower consists of customer name and the loan number. For each example on set operation, we need to find the set of all the customers who have account at the bank and set of all the customers who have a loan at the bank. Consider the example of union. Find all the customers who have a loan and account or both at the bank. In these two tables, customer name shown in blue box have a loan and account or both at the bank. So the result contains 9 tuples. And we write the query as select customer name from depositor, union, select customer name from borrower. Here union clause produces distinct values in the result set. Hence, the 9 tuples will be in the result instead of all the tuples of depositor and the borrower, that is 14 tuples. Set operation union all. Suppose a tuple occurs m times in the relation r and n times in the relation s, then it occurs m plus n times in r union all s. If Jones has 4 accounts and 3 loans at the bank, then there will be 7 tuples with the name Jones in the result. Example of union all. Find all the customers who have a loan and account or both at the bank. So the relation required are depositor and the borrower. As we have to use union all operator, it fetches all the tuples of the depositor and the borrower. Hence, the result contains all the tuples of depositor as well as the borrower, that is 14 tuples. The query for this example can be written as select customer name from depositor, union all, select customer name from the borrower. Set operation intersect and intersect all. The intersect operator is used to find the intersection of the data sets of the two select statements. The number and the type of the field present in the two data sets must be same and similar. The intersect clause produces distinct values in the result set, and to fetch the duplicate values too, intersect all must be used instead of the intersect. The syntax for the intersect is select column name from table 1, intersect, select column name from the table 2. And the syntax for the intersect all is select column name from table 1, intersect all, select column name from table 2. Example, find all customers who have a loan and an account at the bank. So here we have to find out the customer name which are common in depositor as well as the borrower relation. In both table, customer name Hayes, Jones and Smith are common customer name. But the intersect operator produces distinct values in the result set. Hence, the result contains three customer names Hayes, Jones and Smith. Even if the depositor relation contains two tuples for the customer name Hayes and the borrower relation contains two tuples for the customer name Smith. Hence, the query using intersect operator can be written as select customer name from depositor, intersect, select customer name from the borrower, and the result contained the distinct tuples from both the relation. Set operation intersect all. Suppose a tuple occurs m times in the relation r and n times in the relation s, then it occurs minimum of m comma n times in the r intersect all s. If John has 4 accounts and 3 loans at the bank, then there will be 3 tuples with the name Jones in the result, that is the minimum of 4 accounts and 3 loans equals to 3 tuples. Example of intersect all operator. Find all customers who have a loan and account at the bank. So the relation required are depositor and the borrower. Common customer name are Hayes, Jones and Smith. Even if in the relation depositor there are 3 tuples for the Hayes and in the relation borrower 2 tuples for the Hayes, the operator intersect all will contain the minimum of 3 accounts and 2 loans, that is only 2 tuples for the Hayes in the result, and same for the customer name Smith. Hence the result contains the 4 tuples. We can write the query for this example as select customer name from depositor, intersect all, select customer name from borrower. Set operation except and except all. The except operator is used to combine the two select statements and return the row from the first select statement that are not returned by the second select statement. The except clause produces distinct values in the result set, and to face the duplicate values too, except all must be used instead of just except. The syntax for the except operator is given here. And the syntax for the except all operator is select column name from table 1, except all, select column name from table 2. Example of the except operator, find all the customers who have an account but no loan at the bank. So here we have to consider those tuples from the relation depositor which are not there in the relation borrower. In the depositor relation, 2 rows for the Johnson, Lindsay and the Turner shown in the blue box are there in the relation depositor but not in the relation borrower. The customer name Hayes, Jones and Smith shown in the red box are common to both the relation. Hence these names will not be there in the result of this example. Hence the result of this example contains 3 customer names Johnson, Lindsay and the Turner. Even if the relation depositor contains 2 tuples for the Johnson, but because of the except operator, the result contains only 1 tuple for the Johnson. The query for this example using except is select customer name from depositor, except select customer name from the borrower. Set operation except all. Suppose a tuple occurs m times in the relation r and n times in the relation s, then it occurs max of 0, m minus n times in the r except all s. If the John has 4 account and the 3 loans at the bank, then there will be max of 0, 4 accounts minus 3 loans equals to 1. That is max of 0, 1 is 1. So only 1 tuple will be in the result of except all. If the Jones has 3 accounts and 4 loans at the bank, then there will be max of 0, 3 accounts minus 4 loans equals to minus 1. That is max of 0, minus 1 is 0. So there will not be any tuple in the result of except all. Consider the example of except all operator. Find all the customers who have account but no loan at the bank. In depositor relation, two tuples for the Johnson, one tuple for the Lindsay and the Turner shown in the blue box are there in the relation depositor but not in the relation borrower. Hence, except all operator consider both the tuple for the Johnson as max of 0,2 account for the Johnson minus 0 loan for the Johnson equals to 2. Hence, there will be 4 tuples in the result of this example. The query for this example is select customer name from depositor, except all select customer name from the borrower. Till now, we consider the various set operation. Now pause this video and reflect on this question for a minute or 2 minutes and write your response. Once you return the answer to these questions, then you can restart playing this video. Question is, if the customer has 2 accounts and 3 loans at the bank, then how many tuples will be there in the union all, intersect all and the except all? I hope all of you have completed this activity. Suppose a tuple occurs m times in the relation R and n times in the relation S, then it occurs m plus n times in the R union all S, minimum of m comma n times in the R intersect all S, max of 0 comma m minus 1 times in the R except all S. If the customer has 2 accounts and 3 loans at the bank, then the number of tuples will be in union all, that is 5, intersect all 2, except all 0. These are some references. Thank you.